Good afternoon. My name is Phil Favela, Career Services Coordinator and Master of Today's Ceremony. Welcome to our 2021 Gernick Academy graduation ceremony. Please, everyone, stand for our national anthem. Please be seated. This morning, I would first like to welcome our esteemed guests, faculty, family, and friends. Thank you all for joining us as we celebrate the perseverance, hard work, and accomplishments of our graduate students. This is a joyous moment for our students, their family, friends, and all of us here at Gernick Academy. Seeing graduates, families, friends, staff, and faculty here today is a testament to the achievements of the graduates and the love and support they have received over the months they have studied and learned with us. Today is a fun part. Over the past few months, we've seen the graduates work exceptionally hard. The staff and faculty remember when you first began your Gernick experience. We are blessed to have had the privilege of helping you with your educational goals. Today's graduation ceremony represents a monumentous experience for all the students. It symbolizes the completion of education requirements that will enable them to enter their chosen profession. I hope all of us here today can take this personal accomplishment as an example of how anything is truly possible when you put your minds to it. It is with great honor to introduce the Executive Director of WellBe Health, Sequoia Pace, and honorary guest speaker this morning, Mindy Wilds.
Good morning. Thank you all for having me here. Morning, y'all. Long hours studying for an exam or writing a paper, being the only person to work on a group project, up until 2 a.m. doing prep work for clinicals that start at 7 a.m. What do all of these things have in common? They're hard. They can be frustrating, and they may even leave you feeling defeated about your choice in healthcare. Once you get onto that clinical site, you form a bond with your patient, you enjoy getting to know them and take care of them, then your assignment is over, and you lose contact with that patient, and you lose that connection. What's that all about? It's disappointing, and it can be a little bit of a struggle sometimes to deal with. This one is really, really hits home, I'm sure. Go to school during a pandemic. Lose your clinical site as everything moves to remote learning. Have kids or a spouse at home, also using the Wi-Fi and scrambling for screen time. Experience a fear of the unknown. What's the common theme here? It's hard. School is hard. Studying is hard. Balancing family and jobs and school is hard. but y'all are done with that for now. Healthcare is hard. Taking care of people is hard. Taking care of people when they are in pain, when they're scared and vulnerable is hard. It makes people grumpy, it makes them lash out. We in healthcare get a front row seat to hard decisions that patients and family members have to make at times. Supporting them through those things can be hard. It can be taxing and can take a toll on us as caregivers. I remember one case in particular that has stuck with me for years. A set of newborn twins who were exposed to whooping cough while being cared for by family members in Mexico while their mother worked. The babies were on the pediatric floor for a few days. They got fluids, antibiotics, supplemental O2. They appeared to be turning around, and they were discharged home. Within 24 hours, they were back in the emergency room, and unfortunately, one of the babies died in the emergency room. Her sister was brought to us in the pediatric ICU where I worked. We worked to stabilize her for the entire shift, and unfortunately, the infection was too much, and she also succumbed to death. Hearing that mother wail in the room when we told her the news was one of the hardest things I've ever done as a nurse. It was a guttural sound of sorts that reverberated throughout the entire ICU and stuck with those of us working that day for years to come. I say all that to say again, healthcare is hard. All of these examples as to why taking care of folks is hard, yet each and every one of you chose to accept that challenge and are beginning or continuing your career in the healthcare field. Congratulations to all of you for doing that. That being said, all of the horrible things we see happen to people, with the hurt we see caused by others or themselves, the innocent lives affected, the injustices we see that happens to others, this chosen profession of ours can put you into a funk if you're not careful. So, here comes the good part. I'd like to turn this around a little bit and share a few things that have been helpful for me in my 26-year career as a nurse. One thing to note, though, I haven't always been this optimistic or this introspective about things like this. I think part of that has come with age and maturity as a person and also in my profession. I am no longer the adrenaline junkie ICU nurse, jaded about life by drunk drivers or people who shake babies. I liken myself now to more of the wise old owl kind of vibe, here to provide guidance and support to the team I am called to lead. One of the ways I do that is by finding and sharing meaningful to me quotes on social media. I find out from people's messages or comments that they aren't just meaningful to me though, but they're also meaningful to others. So let's begin. The first one, you run the day or the day runs you, you choose. This one has helped me in so many ways get into a routine in which my days, especially during the work week, look very familiar. I try to get up early, work out first thing in the morning, get ready for work. And the thing that has really helped me when I get into work, I start my day by writing down 2 to 3 things I'm thankful for. This has helped me start just from working from a place of thankfulness. It can be simple things like good rest the night before, cooler weather, that was one several days here in Fresno a couple weeks ago, or even just being thankful for the ability to move my body in the morning during my workout. I also write down 2 to 3 goals for the day. Again, nothing monumental. Sometimes it's as easy as just cross 2 things off my to-do list or call my parents. But again, I'm a visual person, so seeing those things written down and then actually crossed off helps me feel better. It just makes me realize that I am in charge of the day. Another one that I like to consider often is yesterday is heavy, put it down. This one is especially meaningful when it feels like you can't get ahead of things on your to-do list or you're getting lost in so many tasks that drag over from one day to the next. We sometimes ruminate about what should have been done that we didn't get done. Guess what, friends? That was yesterday. Leave it there and move on. A third favorite of mine is choose happy. It's short and sweet and so simple, yet is it? My happiness in life is my choice. I have 100% ownership and accountability of that happiness every morning, and so do you. I make the choice to be happy. I make the choice to remain happy throughout the day, with deadlines looming, people asking hard questions. I mean, it's not always unicorns and rainbows, but we certainly try to make the best of it. I feel that a team takes on the attitude and vibe of their leader, and I want my team to be happy, optimistic, problem solvers. I want to give them the tools that they need to do their job. This next one is from a favorite author and motivational speaker of mine, Brené Brown. Love me some Brené Brown. She says, talk to yourself like you would someone you love. And I'm gonna say, as the mama, first of all, of a teenage daughter, I love this one just so much. I feel like this is so important for us to hear, digest, and believe. Again, in healthcare, we are caregivers. We are so dedicated to taking care of everything for others that we sometimes forget to take care of ourselves. Taking care of us entails not just pedicures, massages, and splurging on a new pair of shoes, but it also includes protecting us from the negative voices in our head. I do it. I get stuck in those negative voices in my head, and I know a lot of other people do as well. But I would strongly encourage you to speak kindly to yourself. Finally, the last one is a quote that I love so much that I have it hanging in my office, and this one resonates with me because of the career path I've been called to serve in as a nurse. As a nurse caring for patients in the county hospital 20 years ago, to the nurse and the executive director of a program that cares for participants who aren't always the easiest to take care of. This one says, I'm not interested in whether you've stood with the great. I'm interested in whether you've sat with the broken. This defines healthcare today, in my opinion. It defines the way that we interact with our patients and the populations that we serve. It defines the way that we interact with each other as well. It's a great example of vulnerability. It puts us all on an equal playing field, which in turn allows us to take better care of one another. In closing, you have traversed the healthcare education system in a time of uncertainty with a pandemic that no one has a playbook of cliff notes to get through, but you guys have done it. You've chosen to join a profession in a time when science is often challenged and naysayers are everywhere. I want to say thank you for choosing this. Thank you for joining us in one of the best professions. It's hard, it can be painful, emotionally draining at times, but oh so rewarding. Please take care of yourselves. Give yourself grace, use the nice words, and be kind to one another. Thank you.
This afternoon, we honor graduates from our medical assistant program, vocational nurse program, associate of science in ultrasound technology program, associate in science in vocational nursing program, and the associate in science of nursing program. We will begin this with the ceremony for the students who have earned the medical assistant certificate. Please welcome Mrs. Jasjit Dhaliwal, medical assistant program supervisor and clinical coordinator.
Hello, everyone. During this part of the MA ceremony, we would first like to recognize some of our students. These students have gone above and beyond during their medical assisting program and have exceeded expectations. We will recognize these students for their outstanding academic performance, leadership, and attendance. Students, as you are called, please rise and come forward. In recognition of achieving perfect attendance, Munsimran Kaur, please come forward. And finally, one last recognition, a recognition of outstanding academic achievement and receiving highest ranked GPA in the class and achieving valedictorian, Munsimran Kaur, please come back up. Thank you, students, for your dedication to the MA program.
Medical assistant graduates, please stand. When your name is called, please come forward to receive your certificate. Munsimran Kaur. We will now honor graduates who have earned the Vocational Nurse Diploma. Please welcome Mrs. Heather Mathis, Assistant Vocational Nurse Program Coordinator.
Good morning. During this part of the VN ceremony, we would first like to recognize some of our students. These students have gone above and beyond during their vocational nurse program and have exceeded expectations. We will recognize these students first for their outstanding academic performance, leadership, and attendance. Students, as you are called, please rise and come forward. In recognition of achieving perfect attendance, Ruben Valencia, please come forward. In recognition of their dedication to continued education and invaluable contribution to the Student Ambassador Council, please welcome Avdeep Dillon, Ashley Flores, and Anahi Islas. In recognition of outstanding academic achievement with the second highest ranked GPA in the cohort and achieving salutatorian, Angelina Booker, please come forward. And finally, in recognition of outstanding academic achievement with the highest ranked GPA in the cohort and achieving valedictorian, Gagandeep Kaur and Rupinder Kaur from VN49. Thank you, students, for your dedication to the VN program.
Vocational nurse graduates, please all stand when your name is called. Please come forward to receive your diploma. Amandeep Kaur. Angelina Booker. Shelby Cronister. Avdeep Dillon. Kaylee Edmonds. Jennifer Farias. Nina Felton. Ashley Flores. Coming with all that. Monique Foster. Jeanette Galavan. Mahogany Henley. N.I.E. Islas. Amanpreet Kaur. Gagandeep Kaur. Harpinder Kaur. Jeskert Kaur. Manpreet Kaur. Prabhjot Kaur. Rupinder Kaur. Rupinder Kaur. Satinder Kaur. Sujit Kaur. Kaseya Lewis. Karina Limon. Anna Marquez. Alyssa Mina. Laquisha Mitchell. Carmen Morales. Monica Morales. Regina Ornelas. Jessica Perez. Brenda Prince. Guadalupe Ramirez. Angelina Rodriguez. Anmal Samra. Brianna Sanchez. Janelle Sarabia. Michelle Savala. Oscar Uribe. Ruben Valencia. Karina Valenzuela. Lily Vang. Pa Nia Vang. Moses Vargas. Magda Lucia Venezuela. Oh, Velasquez. Kiara Vinces. And Aaliyah White.
Good morning. During this part of the ASUT ceremony, we would first like to recognize some of our students. These students have gone above and beyond during their Associate of Science in Ultrasound Technology program and have exceeded expectations. We will recognize these students first for their outstanding academic performance, leadership, and attendance. Students, as you are called, please rise and come forward. In recognition of achieving perfect attendance, Elisa Oliveira Perez, please come forward. In recognition of their dedication to continued education and invaluable contribution to the Student Ambassador Council, Micah Pope Allred, please come forward. in recognition of outstanding academic achievement with the second highest ranked GPA in the cohort and achieving salutatorian, Elisa Oliveira Perez, please come forward. Thank you, students, for your dedication to the Associate of Science and Ultrasound Technology program.
Ultrasound Technology graduates, please all stand. When your name is called, please come forward to receive your degrees. Elisa Oliveira Perez. Micah Pope Allred. Stephanie Villalobos. Associate of Science and Vocational Nursing graduates, please all stand. When your name is called, please come forward to receive your ASVN degrees. Danielle Abbott. Fatmara Bangura Boyk. Christine Guevara. Lorraine Gutierrez. Prabdeep Kaur. Mariah Keane. Sylvia Sandoval. Rebecca Tolbert. Elizabeth Worley. Thank you. You're coming back. Thank you, guys. We will now honor graduates who have earned the Associate of Sciences in Nursing. Please welcome Mrs. Guadalupe Otero again. ADN Assistant Program Director.
Good afternoon. During this part of the ADN ceremony, we would first like to recognize some of our students. These students have gone above and beyond during their Associate of Science in Nursing and have exceeded expectations. We would like to recognize these students first for their outstanding academic performance, leadership, and attendance. Students, as you are called, please rise and come forward. In recognition of achievement of perfect attendance, Ashley Manny. Just read that. Okay. Thank you, students, for your dedication to the ADN program.
Associate of Science Nursing graduates, please all stand. When your name is called, please come forward to receive your degrees. Francesca Avalos. Juan Estrada. Rhea Kumar. Ashley Manning. Eric Reyes. Monica Reyes. Simarjeet Sahota. Sarah Solario. Catherine Villanueva. It is with great honor that I introduce Guernica Academy's Fresno Campus VN Assistant Program Coordinator, Mrs. Heather Mathis.
Let me just bring this up a little bit. At this time, we would like to continue our time-honored tradition and publicly recognize our graduating veterans and active duty personnel with a special red, white, and blue honor cord in recognition of their service to our country. Honor cords are one way to show our veterans how much we appreciate their service in addition to the pride we feel for their latest academic success. Graduating veterans, when I call your name, please come forward.
Please welcome Brenda Prince, representing the Navy. Please welcome Nina Felton, representing the Army. Please welcome Simarjeet Sahota, representing the Army. Please welcome Sylvia Sandoval, representing the Army.
Like to ask all our graduating active duty military personnel and student veterans who have served our country to please stand and be recognized. We thank you for serving in the United States Army, United States Marine Corps, United States Navy, United States Air Force, United States Coast Guard, United States Public Health Service Commission Corps, and the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration Commissioned Officer Corps. Please give them a big round of applause and thank them for their services. Thank you so much. You can be seated. I got this. Graduates, at this time, please all stand. Yeah, give them a big round of applause. As the VN Assistant Program Coordinator of Gernick Academy's Fresno Campus, I confer the respective degrees, diplomas, and certificates on these candidates. So proud of them. Graduates, you may now turn your tassels from the right to the left. On behalf of the Academy, I offer my congratulations to all. I know this has been a very difficult time to be in school in general, and I just thank you guys for sticking through it, making it to this point, and I thank all of you in the just being here for them, supporting them during their time. Give them all a big round of applause. And give yourselves a round of applause. You did it. You did this, you guys. Lots of hard work. Thank you.
Thank you, graduates. Please take a seat. Throughout this journey, our students have shared many memories together. We have created a slideshow to share some of these memories with all of you.
You were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories. And the memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain. When I believed in forever and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feel like December when somebody say your name. Cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day, yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, yeah. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories. And the memories bring back your. Memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I never felt so lost. And I felt all of the hatred was too powerful to stop. Now my heart feel like an ember and it's lighting up the dark. I'll carry these torches for ya, and you know I'll never drop. Yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright. Gonna raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories. And the memories bring back your. Memories bring back your.
Thank you to all the graduate student services team for the beautiful slideshow. And thank you, students, for sharing your beautiful memories with all of us at Guernica Academy. On behalf of the staff, faculty, and administration of Guernica Academy, I would like to thank all of you for joining us this afternoon. Please remain in your seats until all faculty and all of our graduates have left the auditorium. Thank you very much and have a wonderful weekend.